This is Jason Rios with LGH, and today we're here to talk about different types of slings that we carry in our inventory here at LGH. Our first sling that we're going to discuss is going to be your standard web sling. These standard web slings are only available as a sale item from LGH. They are not available in any of our rental fleets. Your standard web sling is going to have a capacity anywhere from 1,600 to 59,500 pounds. These slings typically come in an I configuration. There are some endless round sling available for these types as well, but most commonly you'll see these in an I to I type configuration. Within those configurations, you can either get a flat I like this one, right, where it's flat to itself, or a twisted I, or any combination thereof you can mix and match. The twisted I is commonly used in an application where you think you're going to be using it in a more of a choke fashion. This sling is a little short for that, so I won't be able to show you the choke configuration, but I think you can get the idea. Common uses for these on job sites. This is your common everyday sling. This is the one you're going to grab when you need to pick something real quick. This will be sitting on the back of the forklift or the loader or whatever it is you're using to pick. It's a very common type sling. It's lightweight. The capacities that it can lift up to compared to its weight make it very convenient to use your standard every day. One of the important things to remember with this type of sling, however, is how you take care of it. These slings are very susceptible to degradation from UV light. So make sure that at the end of the day, you're not leaving these out on the job site or in the back of a pickup truck somewhere. These need to be stored in a location where they're away from damaging sunlight. And then within using these as well, just be careful because it is nylon. These slings are susceptible to cuts and abrasion. Regardless of any type of sling that you're gonna use, every sling will come outfitted with an information tag that is required for that sling to remain in service. In this standard web sling here, you're gonna notice that there's three different capacities listed. You're gonna have your standard vertical capacity, which will be your standard vertical configuration within 6 degrees. You're gonna have your choker configuration, which is always gonna be your lowest rating for that sling. And then additionally, you're also gonna have your basket rating, which in this case will be for a 90 degree basket only. If you plan on using this in any type of rolling block or shiv device, please make sure that you understand the angle at which the sling will come down and you reduce the capacity of that sling likewise. In addition to all the rated capacities, you're also gonna notice it's gonna have a width of the sling, the length of the sling. Moving on, we're gonna move into our endless round slings. These endless round slings will come in capacities from ranging from 21,200 pounds all the way up to 200,000 pounds. These slings are often used in heavy lifts to reduce rigging weight. So if you can imagine, this sling right here, which is an EN360, has a rated capacity of 31,000 pounds, but probably weighs, you know, 20 to 30 pounds, maybe a pound and some change per foot. So if you can imagine being able to pick up 31,000 pounds with only a 10-foot sling, you are able to keep your rigging weight down, which may help your crane or your overhead rig overall rigging weight stay reduced. To care for these slings are designed with this tough Kevlar outer jacket. Now, that doesn't mean they're bulletproof. What it means is that this outer jacket is designed to protect the inner yarns, which actually carry the weight. This jacket itself has no bearing on the lifting of the item in and of itself. So what'll happen is this outer jacket, if it gets torn and the yarns are exposed, this sling will no longer be allowed to be repaired or in service. However, if you tear the jacket but it doesn't go all the way through and does not expose the yarns, you can have one of these patched and repaired at a minimal cost compared to the entirety of the replacement. The information found on the tag of an endless round sling will include the manufacturer's name, the type of sling, the length of sling, and the three rated capacities in a vertical choker or basket hitch. The last sling that I think we're gonna discuss is our standard wire rope sling. As you can see, It's an eye-to-eye configuration. All LGH wire ropes will come with a standard eye-to-eye. These wire ropes are available in capacities from 5.6 tons and 3/4, which is what this one is, a 3/4 inch, all the way up to our 4 inch, which I couldn't lift up if I tried, at 130 tons. So these slings are very standard. You'll see these in most different lifting applications. These are often used in conjunction with, you know, straight lifts, soft baskets, different types of rigging hardware such as shib locks, turnbuckles. They fit easily into shackles. They don't have as much spread as, say, inside the bow of a shackle as, say, a Kevlar might, or even a web sling. More importantly, just protecting these slings from damage. Always inspect these, for broken wires, kinks, bird caging, any other type of defects that you may notice in the sling. It's important to make sure that you're taking care of these. You don't leave them out in the elements to oxidize and thus, you know, reducing their capacity. The standard tag on a wire rope sling will contain the manufacturer's information, the wire rope diameter and length, and the standard three configurations found on all sling tags, which would indicate vertical, choker, and basket hitch capacity. Thank you for watching this sling comparison video. If you have any further questions, please contact us here.